Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how you can embed a YouTube video inside a Keynote presentation. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a new feature in Mac and iOS Keynote allows you to embed YouTube and Vimeo videos directly into a slide in your presentation. This feature was added to Pages and Numbers earlier this year, but it really belongs in Keynote because quite often when you're giving a presentation, you want to show a YouTube video inside the presentation on a slide. In the past, we've had to switch to our browser, show the video there, and then switch back to the presentation. Now that video can be right in the presentation. You never have to leave it. So to start, make sure you're using the latest version of Keynote, version 10.2 or newer. Let's create a new presentation here. I'm going to use a basic color presentation, something pretty simple. And let's add a new slide. I'll add a blank slide here. Now to put a YouTube video on this slide, all we need to do is go to Insert and then Web Video. And then here we need to paste in the URL of the YouTube or Vimeo video. So let's grab one of my own videos here. This is a YouTube video from earlier in the year. And all you need to do is grab the URL. So something like this here at the top, YouTube has a variety of different URLs and any of those should work. It's going to be able to figure it out. So I'll copy this and then switch back to Keynote and I'm going to paste it in here. And you can see it comes up with a preview. It shows the thumbnail, it shows the title, and it shows the creator of that video. Then I'll just click Insert and now the video's in there just as a regular element on the slide. I can move it around. I could grab a corner or side and resize it. I can preview it if I want by clicking play right here and it will load it up. And you can see it looks just like if I took the YouTube code to embed this in a web page. You get the YouTube logo, you get settings, you get closed captioning, you've got volume controls, playback controls, things like that. You even have the control here to airplay the video. Anything that's like a link, like clicking on one of these videos to view or share, it's going to take you out to the YouTube website. Now you can do a variety of things with this element here in addition to resizing it. In the format sidebar here under web video, I could see the URL and click it to go to that web page. I could also click the replace button and then be able to enter another URL here and replace this with another video. The new title and caption features are here just like they are for images and shapes. So I can turn these on and then I can add a title or add a caption. And I can set it to be top or bottom so both the title and caption are at the bottom. So that's optional. You can have that on or off. The only real video option you've got here is load video on click. So right now if I were to play this, it does nothing until I click and then it will start the video. In fact, if I go to view and then show build order, I could see here it appears in the build order just like any animation or transition. And it's set to on click. If I switch to after transition, you could see this checkbox goes off. So these are basically one and the same. You could set a delay right here so you could have it start after say a delay of 5 seconds on this slide. The arrange tools are typical for an image, but they're really pretty limited for a video. So you could set the size here. If you uncheck constrained proportions, it will seem to work like that. But in fact, when you play it back, it's still going to just fit within that rectangle. You can't rotate it. Another thing about videos is they don't really work very well with other elements. So for instance, if I take a shape here and I were to put a rounded rectangle and maybe have it cover a portion of this video, if I play it back, you could see it does cover it while it's still just showing the thumbnail. But as soon as I start playing, you could see it covers that. If I were to copy and paste this into the shape, then it doesn't work at all. And actually, if I were to group these together, it doesn't work at all. So it doesn't really play nice with other elements. But you could still stick things behind it. So I could take this rounded rectangle, for instance. I could send it to the back and I could resize it to create kind of a frame for the video. And that will work just fine. On the other hand, you may just want to resize this to basically take up the entire frame of the slide. So this will work while you're presenting the slideshow. So it doesn't really work very well with other things. Recording a slideshow doesn't seem to be able to capture the YouTube video. When I tried it in Keynote Live, it actually worked on the machines that were watching the presentation. But on the presentation machine itself, it played the audio but not the video for some reason. So it kind of worked. It doesn't work if you export as video. It's not going to capture the YouTube video there. And it doesn't seem to work when you're recording a slideshow either. So this definitely seems like it's more for use in a traditional presentation situation, like at the front of a room or during a meeting. But even so, I think this is going to be incredibly useful and will replace the old switch to the browser and then switch back to Keynote method that everybody's been using up until now. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.